I believe these are written for bassoon, but they work great on bass clarinet, and they work great on clarinet as well. Saxophone, not so much. They go too low for the saxophone, but they're great for clarinet and bass clarinet, so I totally recommend them. You can download this one right here. This is the one that I played, and you can play it yourself or follow along as we talk about it. There are a couple of significant challenges associated with this particular study. The first one is the fact that there's basically nowhere to breathe, and the second is that you go over the break and back down under the break a bunch. I'll play you exactly what I'm talking about here. So when you're playing these throat tones, those notes have this special feature about them in that they can be played while your right hand is down. I'm gonna show you what I mean. Let me get a little bit closer to you so you can see this. Okay, so an open G. Here's the thing. So I can actually play that open G and put my right hand down, and it basically sounds the same. Check it out. And you can do this also for A flat and A and B flat. When you start going lower to like F sharp and F, you can start hearing it go a little bit flat. Now, and there it goes down to a low E flat. Now, there's some of the notes down there that obviously you can't keep your right hand down with, but so many of them you can. So why do you even care that you can keep your right hand down? Why am I even talking about this? Well, here's the reason why. Coordinating two hands is harder than coordinating just one hand's worth of fingers. When you have two hands from like an open G, which is like nothing, to playing, let's say a C, which is using eight of your fingers, you have to coordinate two hands worth, eight fingers worth, and they all have to go down at the same time. Now for a lot of people, that's difficult. Now what if you could leave your right hand down while you're playing that open G and just move your left hand? You can do it a lot faster, and there is much, much less opportunity for error. Error being wrong notes, or even worse, squeaks. So that's the benefit of being able to hold your right hand down for certain notes. So you have to practice and write in which notes so you can get used to it. You can hold your right hand down for. That allows me, I could play this as quickly as something, I don't know, let's try this. So I can play those super fast because I'm really not doing anything with my right hand. It's just kind of hanging out, lazily holding the notes down. It's a trick that a lot of people don't know about, but it's totally legit. You are not cheating by doing this. All right, so the second thing I want to talk about is the fact that there's nowhere to breathe. Now, you have a couple of options when you have to take a breath. You can play until you run out of breath, take a breath, and then keep playing, which totally messes with the phrasing and the time, the rhythm, of the piece of music that you're playing. And so on. What it means is it just splits the music up into shorter phrases than you probably want. Now, if you don't know how to circular breathe, and if you'd like to learn, you can go see that other video of mine, you have the option of, get this, leaving notes out. Now, here's the crazy thing. It actually sounds better in certain cases when you leave those notes out. You have to make a choice which notes to leave out. And you may not know, you know, inherently, oh, well, which one should I, you know. So think about this from a musical standpoint. We have something like, when you're playing that, there are notes that change, and then there are notes that really don't every beat. Now, if you guess that the first notes, the ones that change all of the time, are more important than the ones that are in ostinato and stay the same every beat, you would be right. So if you're gonna make a choice about which notes to leave out, you don't leave out the important notes, you leave out the less important notes. So what it would sound like is if I wanted to take a breath using that same passage that I just played, it would sound something like this. Don't even notice that those notes were left out. And if you weren't watching the score, you would think, oh yeah, that totally makes sense that that's a place to take a breath. So you can do this. Now, here's the catch though. You have to practice doing it. And in order to remember to do it, you need to mark it in your part with a pencil. So what you will do, very simply, is take the notes that you're not going to play and put an X over them, cross them out, and put a breath mark there, and then practice that breath every single time so that you get used to the fact that you're going to breathe there. In fact, you should practice your breaths every time you practice. You practice the notes you play, you should also practice the times that you breathe. It's part of playing. But for this in particular, because you're actually crossing notes out and it might be confusing, you need to practice that in especially so that you don't mess up, you know, when you're actually playing it. So in summary, the first thing that we talked about is the fact that when you're going over the break and back down, especially if you're coming from a throat tone, you can leave your right hand down. Especially, of course, if you're going from a throat tone to something that, you know, that happens in your right hand. This will work with scales, it works with etudes like this. Keeping your right hand down as you're going over and back down under the break is a really, really great way to create more finesse in your playing. And the second thing is being able to strategically leave out certain notes so that you can take a breath. This is totally legal. You have the option of doing it. And if you do it well, no one will even notice. So again, this was the Weisenborn advanced study number 5, as requested by my friend Malcolm in Connecticut for the past, I don't know, like 8 weeks. Here you go, Malcolm. You're welcome. I hope your student does well learning it. And for the rest of you, we will see you next time. Thanks for watching.